Hello, everyone.
Welcome back, everyone. We have Dimitris here, who is going to talk to us about deep learning for making, for automating fish age from otolith images. So I'm going to let you take it away.
Okay, thank you. So let me
Could you make it full screen first? Awesome, yes.
Okay. So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dimitris Politikos from Greece. Currently, I'm a research associate at the Hellenic Center for Marine Research, and I'm going to present you our effort to apply deep learning techniques in fisheries, and particularly how to automate fish age from otolith images. So to get started, the age of fish is a key index in fisheries, providing useful information about the growth rate, mortality, and fishing pressure on fish populations. So otoliths are widely used for fish age determination by counting the, as you can see in the image, counting the annual rings in otoliths. This is a small pieces that extract from the head of the fish. So this process is very often time consuming and costly, and is conducted by experts. So exactly the aim of this study is to explore the feasibility of using neural networks to automate this process of fish age prediction from otolith images. So a few words about the dataset. Fish are collected from national troll surveys conducted in Greek waters. Actually, they are conducted every year. The dataset includes around 5,000 images. With age readings as well the measurements of fish length, and the specific otoliths are from red mullus, red mullet species. In the image you can see some sample images of otolith images, and where the red dots, this is exactly the annual rings. So it's every red dot is 1 year of 1 year of life. So an overview of the dataset. On the left, you can see a histogram of age with the distribution of age groups. So it's from 0 to 5+ a year. So actually, in reality, we had age groups till 11 years, but because greater than 6 years, there are very few, almost 5%. So we merged them in the age group of 5+ group. On the right, you can see the box plot of length per age group. So two comments here. The first is that as the age increases, you expect that the fish length increases. And the second comment is that for a fixed length, you can see that the fish, for instance, of 150 centimeters can belong to two age groups. So this gives us the information that fish length cannot be the single predictor of fish age. So our deep learning approach followed the standard steps when implemented for the classification task with images. So we have the otoliths, first step one, then we have the annotation of otoliths with fish age. We have the split of the data set into training, validation, and testing set. We have the adaption of the neural network. In our case, it's a convolutional neural network, and particularly inception V3. Training of the network by fine-tuning the high parameters. When it's trained, it's evaluated on the testing data set, and then we get the prediction, which in our case, as I said before, it's from age 0 to age 5+, so having total age group. So now we're going to see more detail this fish convolution neural networks. Actually, we use two networks. The first one is the standard network where you have the input image. We pass through the image through the inception V3. This is a state of the art with a good accuracy CNN network, followed by a fully connected layer. And finally, we have the classification task, which is age. And for this reason, we use as a loss function. This is a typical loss function, the categorical cross entropy. The inception V3 is pre-trained on ImageNet with thousands of images and includes almost 22 million of trainable parameters. So this is the first fish network. The second one, what we did is actually that we employed Multitask learning. Multitask learning means that we added at the end an auxiliary task of predicting fish length, except from fish age. So the total loss here is the sum of two losses, of loss age and loss length. And we have two high parameters that they are fine-tuned during training. And actually, they make the interplay between the two tasks. Here, I have a quick review why multitask learning is an important technique for those that were not familiar. So what you have the neural network, and at the end, you have a multiple task. So the basic idea is to join multiple tasks related so to achieve better results. The main idea is that when you have multiple tasks, one task acts as a regularizer of the other tasks. So by this reason, you make the network, you know, you give them harder work in order to achieve better performance. And actually what you do in practice is that you reduce the risk of overfitting. However, tasks should be relevant and properly fine-tuned. Otherwise, multitask learning may not be succeeded. So this is not a straightforward approach. You have to choose related tasks, and also fine-tuning, it's, you know, it needs a lot of effort. So this is an overview, it's a technical slide, an overview of the configuration. Just for instance, you have the six classes I said before. We have the high parameters that they were more important, learning rate, batch size, and the loss weights, the 17, 15, 15% of training, validation, testing sets. We applied regularization techniques, dropout and L1 for reducing the overfitting, and also the loss weights that I told you before, that they were one against the 475, these two values, to balance the multitask learning. So for the evaluation, because we have a classification task, we use the standard metrics of accuracy, precision recall, and F1 score. And the results, I'm going to focus mostly on the F1 score, because actually it integrates all the information from the other metrics. So having all this in mind, we go to the results. I would start with an image that I like very much, because it shows how the inception visualizes the otoliths through its different layers. So you can see that different features, as for instance here, the edges or the central areas of the otolith are highlighted as you go deeper to the network. Here you can see, for instance, you have the edges of the otolith. So going to the classification reports, what you can say is that both networks were very good at predicting younger age classes. You can see here that you have 0.9 for age group 0. And as you go to the older age classes, for instance, age 4 here, you have 0.5. And fish age network is 0.6. So it's the F1 score is, you know, it's moderate. Overall, the fish age network performed better. So the fish age was 0.063, the F1 score, and increased to 0.068. So because this table is, you know, it's very informative, and make more visible, you know, the difference in F1 score between the two networks, we put them in a common plot. So you can see the orange are the fish age length network results. So you can see that in most cases, orange bar are higher than the blue bars, except from the age 0 a group, which was a little bit lower. So what is the nice results that you have age groups that they increase with fish age multitask learn network was more than 20% in several cases. So if we put all the information to give you an overall with not many, you know, numbers and technical details, what you have is that you have a 60-40% success for a fish age network and increase to 69%, almost 69% with a multitask learning. In younger classes, they were more or less the same, but for older classes, the average from 50 to 54 went to 59 to 64%, which is we can say that it's, you know, it's a quite good, I would say, not the best, but, you know, it's an improvement. And here I have another point of view to compare the networks. So what we did is that we got the predicted age mean the 2H minus 2H, so the difference. And as you expect, you know, for both networks, the difference between predicted and true is zero, which is good, which is the perfect prediction. Again, the multitask network did better by 7.4%. And another interesting thing is that for H3 and H-2 difference between two, the Orange network, had very, very little predictions, indicating again that this multitask network, was better. So overall, we can say that we have, a first step, let's say, towards the automatic fits prediction of fades from otolith images. So to conclude, I would like to give you some data science findings and perspectives. So what we liked a lot is that the multitask learning worked. And as I said before, it was not automatic because we tried also fish weight and fish gender and other fish attributes in our networks, and it didn't work, but fish length worked. So multitask learning seems promising that it can improve fish age prediction. And going one step further, we propose to the to the fishery community to explore other potential fish, a lot of characteristics, such as the diameter, the weight, the surface, or the perimeter of the otolith, potentially because they can help further predictability. This is a generic approach, so it can be equally applied to other fish species, and there are many species that, fish otoliths are available. Also, testing other CNNs, except from inception V3, straightforward. We have tested a couple of them, so the accuracy is more or less the same, and ideally, what the fisheries community would like to see is to build a web tool that will automatically detect red mullus age. So giving to the biologist a web tool so they can upload the otolith and return them the fish age. This is our ideal next step. And with this, I close my presentation. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you very much for that presentation. It was amazing. So let me actually check for a sec if we have any questions. There's none on Zoom. Let me also check Discord if we have anything. Nope, I don't think we have any questions. So if you guys have any further questions, please feel free to reach out on Discord to the speaker and on the ML drag. I think he'll be there responding to your questions. And also, I also wanted to thank you very much for the presentation.
Thank you.
It was awesome.